Κάρπαθος όμορφο νησί και μαγικό χωριό μου, με πόνο και με δάκρυα σε φέρνω στο μυαλό μου.
Thousands of pictures, millions of sounds, countless flavors, a complicated riddle, an ambiguous oracle, a secret well kept. Karpathos. Welcome. The effort to come here will be rewarded generously. Situated in the heart of the Carpathian Sea, between Rhodes and Crete, in one of the most difficult crossings of the Aegean. Here, where dancing has no coquettish air or figures, it rigidly throbs while the knees shake the body entirely. The women here dress daily with their traditional costumes, white blouses, kerchiefs, pasumia, traditional shoes, golden florins on their chests. Here, where the famous Kathisto Glendi, seated festival, that is, with lyres and tambounis takes place. Here, where the residents speak a rather peculiar, musical in a sense, language with Doric elements. Often, not always understood, but for sure familiar. Here, where the houses decorated with local, handmade woven textiles and needlework look like small museums. This is Karpathos. Like its dances, introverted but also open-hearted, wild but also hospitable, proud, grand, authentic, a true experience of a lifetime. Unforgettable for whoever makes the effort to take a good look with their eyes and their soul wide open. Mythology wants Karpathos to be the home of the Titans. First resident was the Titan Jupiter, son Uranus, which means sky, and Gaius, earth. The old residents of the island, as tradition says, stole the gods of Olympus and brought them to Karpathos. That's why they were named Arpathei, Karpathei, Karpathian. Mythology also wants the island the place of hospitality for the giants, also children of Gaius. The son of Neptune, Proteus, also lived in the Carpathian Sea. The goddess Athena was brought up here. Prometheus, the god thief, who stole the fire from Zeus so he can offer it to the people, also lived on the island. Liturgy's testimonies mention Minoan sovereignty on the island. Later on it was colonized by the Argeus. Homer called the island Krapatho. The Dorians brought great prosperity to the island. It was at this time that had four cities of importance. This is why during this period the Dorians called Karpathos Tetrapolis, meaning four cities. These cities were the following: Potidaeon or Poseidon, Archesia, Vrucus, and Nisiros. The last is a small, rocky island north of Karpathos, which is now called Saria. Karpathos had the same fate as the rest of the Dodecanese Islands, accepting successive conquerors. During the Middle Ages, the island was renamed Skarpantos. From the mid of the 16th century, the island was conquered by the pirate Barbarossa. He later handed Karpathos over to the Turks. The last didn't live on the island, but only collected taxes. They kept the island under their rule for almost four centuries. It is the time of the revolt in 1821 that Karpathos raised the Greek flag. Lastly, in 1912, they were taken over by the Italian. This is where many Carpathians fled to, so they can get involved in building enterprises. This was followed by a wave towards America. Many Carpathians left to go to Canada, Australia, and Rhodesia. Fewer had Europe as a destination. As far as away as they had gone through, they had Karpathos deeply rooted in their heart. They never abandoned the island, however far away as they were, and they always developed big action. During World War II, the island was taken over by German army, which joined forces with the Italians. The German troops withdrew on October 4, 1944. One day later, the Carpathians began first, in all of the Dodecanese Islands, the revolution against their conquerors. Karpathos is considered an island for tourists that know what they're looking for, and it is. Although you do not notice with a glance, Karpathos is a unique botanical and zoological paradise. Looking carefully at the rocks on the shores, you can't miss the Mavropetrite, black rock bird, and the Aegean seagull. In the beach caves, if you're lucky, you will fall upon a seal, Monachus molachus. There are quite a few that live around the island. Besides, Karpathos is the third area of the country where these Mediterranean seals reproduce. Karpathos is also a welcoming passage for the immigrant birds. The flora on the island is as generous as the fauna. The center region of the island in Spoa, Mesochori and Piles is dominated by a wonderful dense forest. Rich vineyards and fruit trees cover a great part of the island. As for those who love action, Karpathos has many challenges, even for the more demanding. Mild mountain climbing on Lastos, the highest mountain on the Dodecanese Islands. Climbing fields in Kira Panaya. Windsurfing in the renowned beaches in Afiarti. Long walks in one of the many footpaths, which a map recorded, like the Ravine of Lascia, or the journey from Agia Kyriaki to Lariniotissa. A ride to the small island of Seria, on the northern end of the island, with a small boat from Pigadia or the Afani, will persuade even the most mistrustful that Karpathos is a virgin island. Swim in deep blue water next to rocky caves. Explore the strange buildings with the cone-like and semicircle roofs, which were probably built by Saracen pirates, and to walk in the ravine of Endi. Do not hesitate to walk while in Karpathos. Try the rocky but passable journey from Avlona to Vrukunda, the most northern part of the island. Your look should be on the standby so you don't miss the Hellenistic graves, which are carved into the rocks above the beach and the atmospheric underground church. As for swimming, whatever you could possibly ask for, you can find it on the island. Wide sandy beaches, small stones and crystal clear water in Ahata, Apela, Kirapanaya, Agia Mina, Nati and Forokli. The windsurfers love the waves in Agrio Laupotamo in the south, but the swimmers vote for Michaliou Ton Kipo, Michael's garden, and the crystal water in Diakofte. The more popular beaches are located in the tourist resorts, in the small bays of Amopi, in the big sandy beaches in Lefkos, in Agios Nikolaos, St. Nikolaos, and of course in Pigadia. Karpathos will not disappoint the even more demanding tourists, the one who are searching for archaeological beauties. A visit to the museum will instigate you to the prehistory and the history of Karpathos. Crossing the island, you can see the monuments that are left. The chamber tombs in Arkasa and Pigadia, the 18 old Christian royals which are known today, like Agia Fotini or Afati, which is a little out of the capital. Vivid monuments are also the old olive presses, the water mills, the windmills, the rural settlements and the stables. And it is not only this. The things you can see on the surface of the island. There is also a magical underground world that waits patiently for you to discover it. For example, the unrivaled beauty of the cave Limniatis, a little out of Apeiri. A traveler's night is just as fulfilling as the day is, and maybe even more. Your choices, countless. An intense nightlife in the modern clubs around the capital, or a quiet drink at one of the more calming bars. During August, music concerts also take place at the Outdoor Theatre in Pigadia. Also, the excellent municipal choir organizes different shows throughout the summer. Admirers of tradition, the festive holidays, name days, and the famous seated festival. All year round, and especially during the summer, you will fall upon a patronal festival in one of the villages. Karpathos can be reached by ferry from Piraeus, or by air landing at the international airport on the island in Afiatis. To Karpathos, you can also come via roads, or Crete. The residents' attachment to their tradition is moving. The Carpathian House on its own is a small folklore museum with needlework, wooden sculptures and wooden sculptured shelves full of clay jugs and plates. It is also decorated with pictures of parents and grandparents. The floors are often covered with small black and white stones, the seashells, and the roofs are lined with large wooden beams. In the center of each house, there is a large wooden pillar, symbol and prop of the family. A custom of another time is the exceptional costumes the women wore, which you can still see in Olympos. the Cavai and the Sacofustano, parts of the women's costumes one can find on older women in Spoa and Mesohori. The Carpathian Seated Festival is something rather special. It is a chance for the folk songs to be remembered and for each Carpathian taking place to reveal his poetic talent. The most interesting part is the mandinades, small verses, which are thought up on the spur of the moment. The Carpathian mandinades are improvised and quoted by one person, usually regarding a certain topic. Quiet is meaningful. Carpathians hold on tight to their tradition when it comes to their parties. It gives the chance to the whole village to gather. It also gives the chance to the instrument players to distinguish themselves playing. The lyre, the tzambuna, the lute and the violin. Lastly, it gives the chance to the youth of the village to lead the dance. Pano choros, top dance, sousta, springing dance, siganos, slow dance, guanadistos, kneeling dance, fumistos, wedding dance, zervos, dance towards the left, kefalonitika, antipatitis, and archistis. Music is in the blood of the Carpathians. It is said that there are more than 70 different tunes. Some say more than 100. Anyhow, in no other part of Greece does instrument making thrive like it does in Carpathos. In all of the villages, there are people of all ages that make lyres, lutes, tambounis and violins. Most of these people also play these instruments. This love for music, it is said that Apollo, the god of the sound and of music, passed it on to the Carpathians. Apollo is also considered one of the protectors of the island. The local dishes are a sample of the Carpathian housewives' taste and patience. The sardines, the ones made in Spoa, the salted manoula is the most popular. Krithamos, the salted and smashed olives. The macaroones, special pasta. The skaros, very tasty fish. The Carpathian baklava, traditional sweet. This is a momelo, sesame with honey. The triangles, sort of cake. And of course, all these accompanied with fine Carpathian wine. Villages, untouched by time, settled on indomitable but also hospitable rocks. Warm colors that seem like familiar images, although it's the first time you have seen them. Carpathos attracts the attention of a demanding traveler from the first moment. Sometimes it may even shock others that are unsuspected with its intense oppositions. From the newly built capital, Pigathia, until mountainous Olympus, where time seems to have stopped at yesterday. Your look first falls upon Pigavia. The graphic little harbour of Posse gives a small traditional touch to the village, which is mostly deprived by the new buildings. Buildings that look foreign, since most are recently built. The glance spreads from today to yesterday. Taverns, bars, shopping stores, and on the sand the ruins of the ancient church of Aiefotimi, which it is called by the locals. Columns and their capitals and carved pieces from its marble iconostasis from the end of the 5th, beginning of the 6th century. Looking a little more south, you will come upon the Menetes, the village that is built in the shape of an amphitheatre. It was first inhabited during the Middle Ages. The village is dominated by the Assumption of the Mother of God, a large Byzantine church. This church has a miracle-working icon of the Virgin Mary. Before going up the Rock of Menetes, one may stop in Amopi, a very touristy area with many hotels and restaurants. Leaving behind the Church of the Virgin Mary, soon you will arrive to Arcasa, a village next to the sea, also built in the shape of an amphitheater. It is split in two by a small stream, one more tourist resort of the island, which deserves a little more attention. It has its own museum, which was created by the priest of the village. If you continue 2 more miles south, you will find Finiki. It is known for its fresh fish and its fish taverns. It was the center of the mercantile activity of the Phoenicians at the end of 2000 BC. Worth the while to make a stop to try the spaghetti with lobster or the local fish, skaros, which is very tasty. In the center of the island is the village Aperi, the old capital of Karpathos. This village was also built during the Middle Ages, when the residents wanted to leave the villages next to the sea and move to the hinterland. On this side of the island, one's glance must be shared between the steep mountain sides and down by the coast, the beaches, the trademark of Karpathos. Continuing your journey, you come upon the mountainous Bolada, built at the foot of the highest mountain on the Dodecanese Islands, Lastos. And from there, one moves on to Othos with its folklore museum and its well-known taverns. It is worth a stop. After Othos, you reach Piles. White houses with colorful doors and windows and balconies decorated with flowers. Just what is recommended for admiring the sea with a view all the way to Kassos. A little more north is Mesochori. It is a calm village hung above the sea, a natural balcony with generous view to the Aegean. The port here, serving the inland town, is enchanting Lefkos. A tourist resort with beaches that is hard for one to forget. It also has a silent past, which is made up of Agios Yorgos, St. George, and from here we go uphill towards Spoa, the village known for its manoula, small fish, which is located in the middle of the island. The port serving the inland here is Agios Nikolaos, St. Nicholas, graphic and untouched by time. And of course, on the most southern part of the island is the famous village of Olympos and its port, Diafani. Because of its location, it was isolated from the rest of the village for many years. It is a village which may be considered a live museum. Here, more than the rest of the island, the ethics of hundreds of years are kept intact. Houses with intense colors, situated high up on the rocks, hung on the cliff, whitened narrow streets, ruined windmills, and graphic country chapels. The trip in time comes to an end. The ship is now close to its destination. Close your eyes and let the images pass once more before your eyes. There are quite a few, aren't they? It is nothing compared to what the human eye can see in Karpathos, and what a traveller can discover with the eyes of the soul. Anyway, Karpathos, like people that know the island say, you don't see it, you discover it. From the first until the last minute of one's stay on the island, with its different tastes, its inedible scents, its welcoming beaches, its windmills, its untrodden mountain peaks, its colors while twilight falls, its caves that compose one's dream, its everyday chats with small verses, mantinadas, and music. In this ethereal, vivid needlework casted in the Carpathian Sea of Fascination, traveling together in the dream, hope our encounter is good. Rendezvous in Karpathos.